Today, we will be exploring the conservation of energy that is needed to calculate the system of Shaq's basketball slam dunk jump. This is Shaq's jump on Earth, and this is Shaq. He is 147 kilograms, and he is 7 feet tall. The hoop that he has to jump to is 10 feet tall, so the distance between him and the hoop, or the distance in the air, is 3 feet. This is the same as 0.9144 meters. We will need this to calculate future velocity as well as energy produced by the system. Now we are going to calculate the constant velocity with which Shaq leaves the ground and continues his jump. We assume that it is constant, so we can plug into the same equations that we have been using before. So that means the potential energy is equal to the kinetic energy. 1/2 mv squared equals mgh, with a gravitational acceleration of 9.81 meters per second squared. We then put this into the equation to solve for velocity, which is equal to square root of 2 times gravitational acceleration times height in the air. We then plug in the velocity and get that it is 15.05 meters per second. This velocity remains constant, and again, we will now use it to calculate the energy in newtons produced by the system. We now only need the potential energy of gravity, which is mass times gravitational acceleration times height. Then we plug into the equation and get the total energy of the system to be 1318 newtons. To put this into perspective, that is almost 10, or maybe more than 10, high-power leaf blowers. That's crazy. This is Shaq's jump on Mars. For this, we use a different gravitational acceleration. And again, we plug into the formula and get the height. So that would be v squared over 2g. Because Mars has a much weaker gravitational acceleration, the height of Shaq's jump will be much greater. It would be 30.53 meters. That is equal to a 9-story building. 9 stories, that's a lot, and that's a very, very high jump. This is Shaq's jump on Jupiter. Here, the gravitational acceleration is much more than Earth's, which means that gravity is stronger. We again plug into the equation that we used before to get the height, which is a mere 4.57 meters. Shaq's jump is so short that he barely leaves the ground. That must really suck because he can't make his slam dunk. The end. Here's a free cat, and I hope you learned some physics.